opened it. But yeah, I was too excited yesterday to review it. So anyways, here we go. This is how it came, basically. I just like put the case in there. The game is in my 3DS as we speak, but I will show you how it is originally packaged. So just give me a second, I'll just show you how it's packaged. Alright, so how it was packaged is, the game goes there and the stand, which looks like this when your 3DS is on it. Without your 3DS, it looks like this. It's brought to the game, it's easier to play the game, and it's very convenient. People say it's cheap, but it lasts, it looks like it could last forever, man. Depending, you know, just take care of it. So yeah, it's a pretty nice, convenient way to take it around, especially if you're going to a friend's house, you know, don't feel like holding it by one hand. Or you can just alter the controls in the game itself. So I'm gonna put my 3DS back on here. Yep, I've been doing a lot of AR stuff. I collected a couple of these cards from the Nintendo thing we did. I got one in Game Informer. How am I doing here? I got one from Game Informer because I have a subscription to them due to my GameStop Power Up Pro card. Other than that, I've collected these, you know, three from the Nintendo Club, the Club Nintendo program, one from Game Informer, and the rest of them are from the game itself, which was in the case. So before I get to the cards that I have, I'm going to show you what comes inside. What comes inside here is the game, obviously, and it's actually pretty cool because look, it's got the little thumbnails there with the expression of this. They look like that, but yeah. Right, so we have this, and the cool little thumbnails. Ta-da! They're pretty cool looking. There's Medusa, and some weird guy you meet, or whatever. Alright. If you like Candy Crush Uprising, you get all these three games. I already have these three games. I think I haven't reviewed them. It's a little too late to review them now. That's just your basic bat. Registered on the Club Nintendo. I'm not showing that code. And then information about the 3DS stand itself. So here we go. I'm gonna put that back in the case. Now, I also wanted to talk about how awesome, just like, the cards. Let's get back to the cards, yep. Alright, so I have Drill Arm, which is one of the various weapons you can get in the game. There's also Palutena, where there's two Palutena cards in here. There's the non-rare one, and there's the rare one. So then there's Mono Eye, one of the most common enemies in the game. The Great Reaper. I hated facing this guy. Three-headed Heedron. Memories. Okay, so we got the Fortune Bow. Once again, another weapon obtainable during gameplay. Dark Pit. Pit. And the Power of Flight. So those are the cards I got right now. You know, if you have any cards and you know you don't use them, any of the cards I don't have here, please message me. I will pay whatever it takes. I am trying to collect as much cards as I can. I really want to collect a lot of AR cards. So other than that, yep, that's pretty much it. Now let me show you basically what you can do in the game. I just opened up the game. Here it comes. Right. Oh, there's a little intro opening, so let me let you watch that. If you like to watch it, I guess. Hope you can hear that. That's some basic gameplay, I guess. Thank you. Oh, Reaper Eyes. Well, that's that. Let's get to the game. So there's my file. It looks a lot like Super Smash Bros. Brawl, if you notice. Except you can really... I really enjoy doing this for some weird reason. But, oops, hit the back button. I really enjoy doing this. See, like, you can just drag everything around. And still, you know, works. So, you got solo mode. You got the vault. In the vault, it's basically this. Let me just get to it. Ugh. You can look at idols. Which is like what you get from AR cards. You can look at music. Music galleries. Idol toss, it's like you get these weird egg things. Oh, look, I got some. I'll show you an example. If I can carefully drag it without cracking the egg. Let me drag it carefully without cracking the egg. Bear with me here, I'm gonna try and drag a lot of them in there. Oh. It's not very easy. I will start with doing some walkthrough gameplay using the stand later. But right now it's kind of difficult because I'm just sort of reviewing what you can do. Here we go, pull down. Boomba! Whoa, wasn't that nice. Burning palm, what the heck? Oh look, we got another egg. Okay, so let's go back now. Alright, so you got idle toss, you got what was this down here? Ugh. Offering. You can offer stuff to the great goddess of Palutena. The great goddess Palutena. There's also this where you collect pieces. There's also what the hell is over here? There's records. See? The records tell you how what you've done lately. As you can see, there's the AR thing, the little AR card thing folder right there. That book is also how, like, how to play. Options, where you know what options are. Okay. So there's Together. Together is really cool. It's basically online. So there's Far Away and Nearby, and yeah. There's also a little convenient gear thing right there to help you edit your gear. Street Pass. I was not expecting this game to have Street Pass. It has gems. Gems are basically like, you put a weapon inside a gem, whenever you walk by someone who has this game, they get your gem. I got a gem from Spot Pass, and it's like a Palutena gem, I guess. I have to pay to unlock it, which I plan to do very soon. So yeah, that's that, I guess. Yeah. But right now, it's all for now. I'll be doing lots of gameplay later. The solo mode is, you know, they have Move Out, which is launch into battle. They have Arms Alter, buy weapons, use weapons, convert them to hearts, and then you have Practice Range, and that's it.